Right, thank you. Good morning to those of you who are here in this chapel and others in the nearby chapel, and there are others outside. And more particularly, we have, I say, maybe hundreds online, an online congregation in Trinidad and Tobago and overseas. So we share in worship with all of you. God bless you and thank you for being here on behalf of the members of the family. God's grace be with you. I want to do something for the benefit of the online congregation, the many persons who are here, not here, but elsewhere in Trinidad or abroad. I just want to share with you what is happening. We didn't begin as yet. We're singing a hymn, "The Lord's My Shepherd," having prayers. Rishi will read from the book of Psalms. From Romans chapter 8, Sabita will, I have it right? Sabita is going to read, right? And then we have some tributes. I will read them out for you. Tributes by Dr. Vishnu Benjamin, Shivana Inalsingh, Davina Inalsingh, Rishi Inalsingh, and Clem Imber. That's it. Right, and we have the closing hymn and some videos. This is for the benefit of our friends who are not with us in person. So God bless every one of you. Let us begin our morning prayers, our worship. Hear the word of God. Some scripture sentences. Jesus said, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you, so that where I am, there you will also be." The truth, says the Bible, is that Christ has been raised from death, giving us the assurance and promise that those who sleep in death will also be raised to life. Hear this one. Also from the Bible, we're often troubled, like what the casket does to us. That's not in the Bible. We're often troubled, but not crushed. Sometimes we are in doubt, but never in despair. There are many enemies, but we are never without a friend. And though badly hurt at times, we are not destroyed. We know that God, who raised the Lord Jesus to life, will also raise us up with Jesus and take us into his presence. These are not the only scripture readings we will have. As I pointed out, Psalm 90 will follow, and Romans also will be included from the New Testament, Old Testament, Psalm, and Romans 8. God bless you all. Program is for you, this little beautiful one. The hymn is "The Lord's My Shepherd." I want to introduce to you our organist, Mr. Barry Mutu from Chaguanas. Thank you, Barry, for being here. He is organist, soloist, musical director for these hymns. All right, and all of you who are here and elsewhere, I wanted to share in this beautiful hymn that has been inspired by the psalm, and one of the lines in the psalm is, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil." The psalm is put to music. Let us all stand. For his own name's sake. Yet will I fear no ill, for thou art with me. My head the dust, and my cup, goodness and mercy. Thank you, and please be seated. Whatever your faith, whatever your church, your religious affiliation, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Jew, we stand in the presence of God, who is Father and Creator of all mankind. I want you to bow your heads in prayer. Every one of us, speak again to the Divine Father. I cannot do anything, and you cannot do anything in a service like this without his inspiration and his guidance and his wisdom. Pray for that. Remember that God is a spirit, and when we come to him in worship as we do now, we must come in spirit and in truth. Loving Heavenly Father, Creator of all humanity, the Lord of life and death, once more, Lord, we stand amidst the mysteries and the cold silence of the casket, mankind's King of Terrors. O Lord, in sorrow of heart and with frail and tested faith, we commit these solemn moments of worship for your inspiration and guidance. O Lord God, as in humility we minister to this congregation today, make us worthy to bring them to your throne of grace. Almighty God, we pray that you will grant us new streams of wisdom in our reading of your priceless promises in sacred scripture. O Lord, anoint our beloved hymns and give refreshing faith to our faltering prayers, and bless every word of comfort in such times of overwhelming sadness. Almighty God, may the tears of your people be precious in your sight. Sustain, O Lord, with your compassionate love, the Inalsinghs and their family circle. Almighty God, we pray that you will deliver them from sorrow's misery so painful and beyond human understanding. Creator God, we remember with gratitude the life and times of Calvin and all that you enabled your beloved servant to accomplish. Father, we thank you for sharing with us this remarkable person whose faithful friendship made our life more meaningful. Now for him, all sickness and sorrow are ended as you have called him to your heavenly home. O Lord God, as he goes through death's awesome unknown doorway, we pray that he will not walk alone. O Lord Jesus Christ, our beloved shepherd, who yourself walked the way of the old rugged cross, into your gracious keeping we commend our brother, for you, O Lord, have promised to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think. Father, to you be glory and honor through all ages, world without end. Amen. Psalm 90 and Romans 8, and then the musical tribute by Michael.
Psalm 90. Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever you had formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn man to destruction and say, "Return, O children of men." For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past, and like a watch in the night. You carry them away like a flood, they are like a sleep. In the morning, they are like grass which grows up. In the morning, it flourishes and grows up. In the evening, it is cut down and withers. For we have been consumed by your anger, and by your wrath, we are terrified. You have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your countenance. For all our days have passed away in your wrath, we finish our years with a sigh. The days of our lives are 70 years, and if by reason of strength they are 80 years, yet their boast is only labor and sorrow. For it is soon cut off, and we fly away. Amen.
Reading today from the book of Ecclesiastes 3, verses 1 to 8. To everything there's a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what has been planted, time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. Amen.
Yeah, so I don't know how many of you would know that Dr. Inalsingh was also a musician. He gave me some really good advice one day. Shivana brought into my store, and he was giving me a story when he was in Canada playing with his band at a restaurant. And while we were playing and people started to talk, as people were there to eat and to mingle, they started to play louder and louder and louder until the owner had to come and tell them to tone it down. They're not here to hear you. So that was his advice to me in going out and doing those types of gigs. So it's from one musician to another.
Mm-hmm.
They say that all good things come to an end. And it's a gift for all the times that we spend. But the people that we meet along the way, they brighten our day. And even though we go our separate ways, I just want to say, never will forget the things that you've done for me. And even though things may change, in my heart there'll always be you and me. You and me. So never say goodbye till we meet again. And you know you'll be on our minds till the end. And even if our words should go astray, just remember these ones I say, that I never will forget the things that you've done for me. And even though things may change, in my heart they'll always be tears are in her eyes. Wish you didn't have to go. Please believe me, there's just one more thing that I hope you had known, that I never will forget the things that you've done for me. And even though things may change, in my heart they'll always be you.
Thank you, Michael. To him, what a friend we have in Jesus. Beautiful hymn, and you're very fortunate. The words are there on the screen, and some of you have programs. Lovely hymn. It's not a funeral hymn, really. It's a hymn for all time. Some people sing themselves to sleep. We use it on Sunday morning. We use it at home prayer meetings. What a friend we have in Jesus. Friend to all, he shares in and understands human suffering, our sins, our griefs, he understands. It's a privilege, an honor, and a wonderful invitation he has always given to share our problems and also our moments of happiness with him. With him, what a friend we have in Jesus. Stand for this one. Thank you. Sing with us. Oh Lord. our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Every weakness, take it to the Lord. Come, but with a load of care, precious Savior, still our rest. Despise, forsake me. Take and shield me. Thou wilt find a solace. Thank you, and please be seated. Just before I share this sermon with you, I just want to add to all the tributes that will be following just now. We're going to have a lot of tributes, both in from some of our speakers, and we are having videos also. Yes, good. We're going to have a story of the life and times of Doc. So just before I read from the Bible, as we pay tribute, sisters and brothers, to a great friend of the sporting fraternity, I want to refer to you to the 2022 FIFA World Cup in Qatar, in where Argentina won that trophy. Some of you would have followed it. Maybe that's not some of your games, but the player of that tournament was Lionel Messi. Some people say Lionel. Well, he's Spanish. Lionel, that's how the announcers pronounce it. Lionel Messi, the team's captain, the Argentine. As he received a cup for his team and country at the end of the World Cup at Qatar, one of the sports commentators said, he said of Messi, he shakes hands with paradise. He shakes hands with paradise. And he went on to add, he sits in a galaxy of his own. Some of you may not agree. I've also been looking at some videos of who really should be the player of the tournament and the player of all times and the player of our century. Anyhow, you may not agree with the commentator, but he said, and I don't know from which country, it was in English, this is why I was able to remember it, he shakes hands with paradise. Normally you use the word paradise when in times like these. Paradise is about heaven. And this is why I thought it is more appropriate for me to say of Calvin, he shakes hands with paradise and he sits in a galaxy of his own. I borrow these epithets in honoring the memory of our distinguished specialist in sports medicine. And also we remember him and his charitable works, whether it be in the Trinidad and with the Trinidad and Tobago Red Cross Society or the Princess Elizabeth Center, and of course other charities. Dr. Inalsingh served God faithfully, and he loved, and as Jesus asked us, love the Lord thy God. This is the summary of all religion. Love the Lord thy God with your heart and mind and soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. Indeed, in so many ways, shakes hands with paradise as we say goodbye to him. God bless the family and all the others of this wonderful person who touched and blessed the lives of so many persons in Trinidad and Tobago and overseas. Let us unite in prayer. Almighty and eternal God, we give you thanks and praise for the many ways in which you speak to us, and we ask that you will grant your grace as we read again from Holy Scripture, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let me share this story with you. It's about life and death. As I was saying a moment ago, there are many tributes that you will be listening to, and I know many that will follow long after this day is ended. The wonderful story of our friend, Dr. Calvin Inalsingh. So I leave that for the tribute, those who are doing the eulogy and the tributes. Let me speak to myself. So here is someone, and his story is in the Old Testament, in the book of Job, and he's looking at the whole business of dying. And you know, only yesterday I went to a funeral in San Fernando, and I was telling, somebody says, I am here, you know, and so many times we come to the funeral, and I wonder what people get from the funeral and what they add to the funeral service. And in Trinidad, there are many of us who like to say we like to go and show our face. We didn't do that. We're not doing that today, no. We came because we love one who loved us, and that is why we're here. So in this lesson that I'm now going to read to you, a lesson that I love very dearly, a lesson that speaks to me, I want to share it with you. And this person he had been very prosperous in his life, very successful in his life, but he knew one day he was going to die. And hear him. And this is about all of us, eh? In fact, the word all, I have underlined it in my Bible, is there a few times. We are all born weak and helpless. All of us, whatever our station in life, whatever our status and family background and achievements and successes and trophies, we are all born weak and helpless. And the word all comes up again in the next verse. All of us lead the same short and troubled life. And he says it in a nice way. He's using illustration now. He says, we grow and wither as quickly as flowers. I think those flowers are real. They're not going to last too long. We grow, human life can be compared with the flowers. Not only Job is saying this, but it's there in the book of Psalms and elsewhere. We grow and wither as quickly as flowers, and we disappear like shadows. That's human life. And hear what he says. He says about this whole tragedy of living in the world and achieving, and then we grow and wither as quickly as flowers. And he says, Lord, talking to God and talking to himself about his own death, he says, God, there is hope for a tree that has been cut down. It can sprout and come back to life, even though its roots grow old and its stump dies in the ground. With a little water, it will live again. And in the dry season in Trinidad, so many things are getting brown because of the long dry season and the sun. But we know what will happen in the rainy season. Just what Job says, yes, with a little rain, even the stump that we think is dead will sprout to life again. Yes, with a little water it will sprout like a young plant. I'm reading from the Bible. And then he says, but a man dies. How sad it is. How disappointing for us that in the world of nature, the plants that we think are all dead, with a little water they will sprout to life. But a man dies and that is the end of him. He dies and where then is he? Like rivers that stop running and lakes that grow dry, people die, never to rise again. In the world of nature, life comes with a little rain, but not with humanity, he's saying. And he talks to God. He says, God, okay, I accept this. I can't fight it again. He says, I wish you will hide me in the world of the dead, where I must go and all humanity must go. I wish you will hide me in the world of the dead. I am going down to the world of the dead. Hear this, all of you, all of us, who may not have a faith and not too sure about what is going to happen when we go the way of the casket. Hear what he's saying. And he lived thousands of years before Jesus. He didn't know about Easter and resurrection and so on, you know. No. He didn't have a preacher to read for him. He's talking to God. And he said, God, I am going down to the world of the dead. You're going to hide me in the world of the dead. And if you are angry with me, I know the time is going to come. If you're vexed because of my sin, if you're angry because of my wrongdoing, I know you're going to come looking for me. Now the big season is Easter. It's about life. He didn't know about this. He says, God, if a man dies, can he come back to life? I am going to wait for better times. There must be better times after this. I am going in the world of the dead, and no matter how long it takes, he says to God, I know you will come looking for me. Now this is a faith I wish you will have. All of you, all of us, I wish you will have this faith. I am going to the world of the dead. I am going through the valley of the shadow of death, but I know you're going to come looking for me. No matter how miserable a sinner I would have been up there in the world, you are going to come looking for me, he says to God. And when you call, I will wait no matter how long it takes, and I will be answering. I love this. It gives me some faith to live and a greater faith by which to die. Recently I was looking at Rabindranath Tagore. He, in one of his poems in Gitanjali, he said, and death is at my door. And death is at my door. He comes with the summons at my door. It's like the police brings the summons and you can't run. He'd have a way of getting the summons to you. You can't bribe him. You can't tell him, give you more time. No. Tagore says, and death is at my door. He has crossed the unknown. And he has come to me with the summons that I must leave. And Tagore says, and I must take up my lamp. He didn't say, give me time, I must buy a lamp. No, he was prepared, as we all have to be prepared. When death crosses the dark unknown and he comes to us, there's only one thing to do, and we have to respond. And Tagore says in his beautiful poem, I will take up my lamp, and he will leave a dark shadow on my morning. I pray that God will bless us all and we will be ready. Taking up the lamp means that his lamp was always there. And I don't think he was an old man. I don't think he was a sick man. It's for young people and for all of us to be ready that one of these days we have to say goodbye to this world that we love so dearly. Today I pray that God will bless you. I don't know what is your faith about. We have a good faith to live. Eh? We plan for coming here. For 10 o'clock, 10:30. We have a faith for tomorrow. We have a plan for when we retire and when our grandchildren grow up. Ladies and gentlemen, my beloved friends, we have to make a plan for leaving. And there's a story of Easter. There's the story of Good Friday. We're going to sing a lovely hymn, the classic Good Friday hymn, "On a Hill Far Away Stood an Old Rugged Cross." The story of this season is about the love of God that is so amazing, so divine. A love that he shares with every one of us. A forgiving and gracious love. And if we understand and appreciate that now, when we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, the beloved shepherd is surely going to be there with us to lead us and guide us home. Say your prayers. Bow your heads with me. Almighty God, our Father. So often we take life for granted, but we thank you for this morning. We thank you for possibly the birds or the passing vehicles near our house or the alarming clock. Something to wake us, to tell us there's a new day, and we thank you, Lord, that we were able to respond to that because you give us life. Consecrate and bless this life in every one of us, O great giver of life. And when that time comes that we should say goodbye and take our last step away from this world, we pray, God, that you will hear us say, "Well done, good and faithful servant, enter into the blessedness of your Lord." Almighty God, hear us, bless us, forgive us from our many sins, and walk with us this journey that we have to take down here. For we pray as Jesus taught us the family prayer, together, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Shivana, you come here now. You have given me a long program a while ago with all these tributes. I want you to help me. Yes, you do that. Say who he is. I know the Benjamins. I want you to introduce them like that. All your family members and friends, do that. Come. Introduce them, call them up, and tell us about your tributes and so on. And if you have a problem, I'm right here.
Thank you. Well, as we start our tributes, I'm going to ask Dad's cousin, Vishnu Benjamin, Dr. Vishnu Benjamin, most of you all know him as Rodney, to start, and then we will follow with a video tribute by Dad's brother, Amar Inalsingh, and then I'll do my part, followed by Uncle Anup, another brother, then Davina, and then our cousin Dale Roach will do a video tribute, and then Rishi, and then another cousin, Michael. So we have a long list, and I think Professor Imbert is here as well, and he will close our tributes.
I noticed you gave someone in the listing here a minute and 50 seconds. I'm following the tributes, so you as speakers and contributors of the tributes, be careful with that. I did not do this.
This certainly wouldn't be 2 minutes and 16 seconds, but I try to keep it tight. Thanks for a great sermon. I am listening, as I'm getting older, I'm listening to these sermons more and more. Be prepared. 86, good score. Today I will say how it has impacted on me. Were there many boundaries, sixes, fours, or was it a measured innings? I am Rodney Benjamin, and here I go. It is indeed a great honor and privilege to say farewell to a man who has had a profound effect on my life, Uncle Raj. He has been partly responsible for me being who I am today. He knew me from birth, and from an early age, I can recall only positive feelings towards him. I remember him taking Anup and myself to Sangre Grande, where he was the DMO, working both in the district and at the Sangre Grande Hospital. This a formidable and arduous task, and he managed it skillfully and professionally. During these times, I was duly impressed. I remember him suturing a patient in his small office at the side of his house in Sangre Grande. And he treated patients who turned up throughout the day and in the night. I wanted to be like him. During these formative years, I remember his love for his beloved German shepherds, Helga and Pandora, two beautiful animals. He was the toast of Sangre Grande, a handsome, charming, affable doctor who easily assimilated, fraternized, and mixed with every strata in Grande. Of course, his calm, serene, peaceful, and tranquil demeanor would be a valuable asset. A great asset it was, and anyone knowing Calvin will be well served to adopt these characteristics. My memories and admiration for him as a pianist and guitarist, self-taught, and the jam sessions at my home, 46 McDonald Street, are unforgettable. Raj on the guitar, deceased Bal on the piano, Anup and myself on the bongos, and the neighbors, all eyes and ears outside. His musical influence was contagious, so much so that Anup had a band, and that band, consisting of myself and other 12 and 13-year-olds, actually played at a concert at St. Augustine Girls High School. Uncle Raj taught me to play billiards and pool on his billiards table at the home in Tunapuna. He will have all the Trinidad and Tobago champion billiards players on that pool table, including some colorful characters, a guy called Masti Fay, a community leader in Tunapuna. Raj participated in numerous billiards tournaments, being victorious in many. After going to university, I lost the close relationship with him, but I certainly kept abreast of his achievements and accomplishments. His representation on the Trinidad and Tobago Olympic Committee, the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association, and the Trinidad Boxing Board was legendary. We all know his exploits with the WBA, but to me, the hallmark of his medical prowess was formulating international guidelines with the American Sports Medicine Association for boxing injuries. A truly remarkable achievement for a son of the soil. I remember all of Trinidad and Tobago expressing great joy when the ring announcer called the name Dr. Calvin Inalsingh as the ringside doctor for WBA world title fights. Shivana, we are just as proud of you when we hear your name called for the women's WBA championship fights. He was the only boxing official I know who never boxed. Why? Simply put, his personality did not allow it. How can a man of his disposition fight? A sound, measured, even-tempered, calm, serene gentleman who accepted good news and bad news with equanimity will never find himself in adversarial combat. Calvin was a carpenter and joiner. This he started as a hobby at his home in Tunapuna, making chairs and tables and other furniture. Eventually, he opened his own furniture manufacturing factory in Arima. Belying Calvin's cool, calm exterior was an impassioned, impressive, and almost imperious individual. How else could he achieve all these goals without a burning passion and steely nerves? It will be remiss of me not to mention what I think is the greatest contribution of Uncle Raj. all these I spoke about are mundane things, his medicine, his achievements. I think, to me, his greatest contribution, as I said, was his dedication to Princess Elizabeth's home for differently abled children. This spanned nearly four decades, during which time he served as director and later on as chairman of the center. I have had the pleasure to work at the center for the same period of time and can attest to the great strides made at the institution. His passion, pride, hope, and dedication to the handicapped kids was admirable. His vision and foresight sealed the fate of the institution. His amicable relationship with board members, management, and staff resulted in excellent performances with all categories of staff, going beyond the call of duty. He seemed duty-bound to make the institution a success. His latest achievement was the delivery of a spanking new operating theater. I would like to see his contribution rewarded by naming the operating theater after Dr. Calvin Inalsingh. Perhaps someone can take note. To his children, Shivana, Avinash, and Davina, who have all inherited his loving, caring, and nurturing persona, most aptly demonstrated in Avinash, it is hard to find a more caring, loving, and kind soul. Anyone meeting him for the first time will be taken aback by his friendly attitude and accommodating nature. He will always greet you like a long-lost friend, not to maintain his jovial manner. Davina and Shivana share the same personality in this respect, even though a little bit more subdued. To Priya and Krishnanand, you have inherited a great family. To his wife, Marina, whom he loved dearly, and who provided all the sustenance, development, and education for the children, he loved you all. Yes, the loss will be great. The void is difficult to fill. But faith and time are tremendous healers. Calvin has lived a fulfilling life, enhanced others, and healed many, supported, elevated, and hoisted multitudes. We have all learned well from him. May God bless him. Thank you. Six minutes.
Okay. I just wanted to pay my contribution to my brother, who I was so close with for maybe 30 years, a long time. And we had a very, very close relationship. But some of the best times we had was when we played music, because we made an income playing music in Europe, in Aberdeen, in Scotland, and also in Norway, where we went and were very, very popular. Raj was a lead man. He was the guitar player, and it was the time when Elvis Presley was becoming famous. So what Raj would do is he would learn all the Elvis Presley songs, and he would be with the guitar in front of the band and appeal to the audience. And in those days, especially in Europe, there was a big attraction for Elvis Presley. So Raj would kind of mimic him, do all the music and all the styles that he had, including changing the hairstyle, include dressing the collar around the neck, all the details. And what would be very attractive would be not just the music, but also the image that Raj projected. So we benefited from that image, and it gave us a reasonably good set of money as medical students, because we made enough money then, much more than we would have got by any other student job. So we loved it, we loved the music, and we played a lot. So that was really exciting. But what has happened is, you know, time has gone and we play less and less, and I pay much less now. But what I wanted to do is to tell you how we would start the band. When we would start the music, I would play one line on the piano, and then Raj and the rest of the band, including the drums, the bongos, shak shak, everything else would come in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just remind you, play that again. And I'm going to play this time in the hope that maybe he hears. Who knows, he might hear. Okay, I'm going to do that now and just play a line and let you know what it was. That was what we started with. And then the band would just come in and we would sing and do everything together. Well, we are very, very sad, but nevertheless, Raj had a lovely life. I love working with him musically, and he helped a lot as medical students. We loved it, and may he rest in peace. God bless.
Not all heroes wear capes. When you're a child, it is easy to see your parent as a hero. And the real test comes when you're an adult, when the rose-colored lenses come off and you see their strengths and flaws. Our father was a great man. Yes, he stood tall and lived tall in our eyes, but it was the incredible human that he was that set him apart. The old adage, you can't teach an old dog new tricks, didn't apply to my dad. He showed my brother Avinash, my sister Davina, and myself that you're never too young or too old to learn, to explore, or to grow. By 8 years old, we knew how to fix a broken pipe, change a washer, and light a fire, a real fire. His actions always spoke louder than anything, and he was a man of action. For every one professional undertaking in his life, there was always 10 times that was done for charity and for anyone or for any organization that needed him. And this describes our life direction under our father's tutelage. Everything he did, he gave 100%, be it woodworking, gardening, painting, music, and even service to the boxing world. As children, we knew our dad could do anything but cook. He never complained to me when I made him my smoothie blends or grilled vegetables or salads, knowing that if he didn't enjoy it, he just had to call Avinash or Davina to whip up some real food. Our Sunday lunches were always the best. He was always overly cautious, and as youngsters, everything was a negotiation when it came to going out. Dad and Mum made our home our sanctuary. His generous spirit is what made our friends and family welcomed. Our partying, liming, and musical jam sessions were always easy at home. Me on the drums, Davina singing, Dad on the piano, and Avinash played the 280ZX. He loved Mum and all the family and was always there for them. His protective instincts were constant, even as we shared a lot in and around the boxing world as professionals and as a family. On one of our boxing trips together in Lima, Peru, after some heavy negotiations, he agreed that I could leave him behind for 2 days so I could go to explore the floating city at Lake Titicaca. While heading back to the airport to meet him, I got caught in a riot and almost missed my flight. I had to jump on the back of a motorcycle of a stranger, and it took me 2 days to tell him about that adventure. His dry sense of humor was legendary. I remember dating a boy who had suffered a deep gash along one finger, and it required stitches, and I asked Dad to help. It was one of the first occasions that they would be meeting. Dad greeted him at the door with a beaming smile, and in true prankster form, he carried two long rusty knives in either hand and said, "Where's the patient? I'm ready for surgery." You could only imagine the rest. His love never wavered. When we were children, we were guaranteed three kisses each day. First in the morning, before he left for work. Another when he returned, and the last at bedtime. This changed to two when he stopped working 3 years ago. As he started to slow, we shared one of our last big trips together in 2018 to our friends Sabita and Michael in Ireland, who are here today. Thank you for the love and care you have showed Dad and for all the great memories. Thank you to Uncle Ranji, Rishi and Geeta also, for your recent visit with us, having you all at home and sharing so much quality family time together with Auntie Savi, Uncle Anoop, Auntie Wilma, and our new additions to our family, Alicia, Samara, and Zara, is something that Dad will always cherish as much as we do. I'm pretty sure that Waldo Emerson was speaking of our dad when he wrote the following: "To laugh often and much, to win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children, to earn the appreciation of honest critics and endure the betrayal of false friends, to appreciate beauty and to find the best in others, to leave the world a better place, whether by a healthy garden, a healthy child, a garden patch, and to know that one life has breathed easier because you have lived. This is to have succeeded. Thank you, Dad, our hero."
I am unable to attend this funeral because of my health is very questionable, and I don't have the strength to come to it. I'm very upset that I won't be able to come, but my love and blessings are there for the family. I am the youngest of the Inalsingh clan, and I've been honored and blessed to be part of this family. Being the last Inalsingh, I was fortunate to get the qualities of my elder brothers and sister. Family was always a big thing, and my mother made sure of that. It was instilled into us from the time we were children, and it continued so. My mother was the matriarch of the family and educated six of us up to a university level. I do not know how she did it, but she did it. But we were blessed and thankful for it. Now I must come to my brother Calvin, who was always a gentleman, kind-hearted man, and was always had the time for everyone, especially his family. Nothing was ever a problem for him, and his advice was always on point. I do miss him so much and will always remember the good times we shared together. May he be blessed with everlasting love and happiness. I love you, big brother. You will be missed but never forgotten. Thank you all for remembering the Inalsingh family. Okay.
Good morning.
Dad, you've guided and molded us into the adults we are today. You prepared us for the journey of life, for which We are forever grateful. My father was a kind, generous, loving gentleman. He touched many lives in a positive, healing way. The ring of warm stories are endless. I learned appreciation from you, Dad. As a child growing up, it was tradition when Daddy came home from work, we always would give him a kiss. As a teenager, one day, when Dad returned home from work, I didn't give him a kiss. It was only because I thought I felt like if I was an adult, and I felt embarrassed. Later that evening, Dad called me into his room and asked me why I didn't give him a kiss. And I said, well, I'm an adult now, and I feel a little embarrassed to give you a kiss. He stayed quiet, and he said to me, Davina, throughout your life, you will have several boyfriends. You may even have several husbands, I don't know. But always remember, you will only have one dad. After that day, I kissed him every day. You shared your experience and value of honesty with me. One day, I remember Dad calling me when he was from the Princess Elizabeth home. He wanted me to switch the television on so he can watch his football game immediately when he got home. He was running late and decided to use the bus route. He didn't have a bus route pass. He was pulled over by the police officer. He told the officer that he was a doctor and he had an emergency in the Arima hospital. The officer followed my dad all the way to Arima. Nevertheless, he had to drive back down on the main road to get home, and he missed the whole football match. Dad, you showed me that your word is your bond, even if it meant getting a leg cramp. Before getting my driver's license, I always asked if he would let me use his car. He had a white sports car, a 280 ZX. He always replied yes, until the day I got my license. So, he was apprehensive when I asked him, but he knew that he would let me down if I didn't get to drive. We drove from home to Carenage, heading down the islands. When we arrived, I parked and jumped out of the car, very excited. Dad remained sitting in the passenger side. I walked across to the passenger side and opened the door. I said, Daddy, we reach. He said, yes, I know. I'm just thawing out. I have a leg cramp from mashing bricks on this side. His sense of humor was dry and priceless. Your kindness, Dad, and care for others is a quality I wish to have in honor of you. Dad had a paid forward style, and I experienced what it felt like for his blessings to fall on me. As a child, on several occasions, visitors would come home to our house with their car trunks filled with plums, sometimes oranges, sometimes mangoes. I never understood until many years later. One night, after driving home from a party with my friends, I was pulled over by a police officer. I was a designated driver. I gave the officer my driver's license, and he asked if I was related to Dr. Inalsingh from Arima. I said, yes, he's my dad. The officer was excited to tell me that my dad was his family doctor. In his own words, he said, your dad look after my whole family and never charge me a penny. I used to bring plums and mangoes and oranges for him. From you as his little daughter? And I said, yes. He said, you get big. We chatted for a while, and he explained that when he was younger and he was not working during the time Daddy cared for him and his family, he would only pay Dad with fruits that he had from his land. That police officer followed me home and helped me drop my friends home as well. And he said to me, I had to make sure Doc daughter get home safe. Your daddy look after me, I go look after you. The passing of our dad would leave a void in our hearts. No parent goes to the University of Parenting. But Dad, you had a PhD in parenting and how to dote on your children. He loved us. He was supportive of us. And yeah, he was proud of us. I speak now on behalf of Avi and Shiv. We can't choose our parents. But if we had to, we would choose our dad over and over again. Thank you.
This message is for Auntie Marina, Shivana, Abhinesh, and Divina. I'm very sorry for your loss. Uncle Calvin was a very special person to all of us, and a very special person to me, my mom, and my father. As you may know, Uncle Calvin and Auntie Marina are met together because of my parents. And since then, there's always been a very special relationship with all four of them. When Divina was 18 years old, there was a decision made for her to come to New York. And of course, Uncle Calvin wasn't too crazy about the idea. And with some coaching from my mom and my dad's part, he allowed Divina to come to New York. But that came with one caveat. My mom and Uncle Calvin kind of communicated to the fact that he would communicate with my mom every week on Divina's whereabouts and what she was doing without Divina knowing about it. So everything Divina thought she was getting away with, Uncle Calvin always knew. And this went on for about a year. And after that year, my mom asked Uncle Calvin, "Uncle Calvin, you think we can relax on the reins on Divina?" And he said, "Okay, fine. Instead of calling me every week, call me every 2 weeks." And that was it. And that went on for another 2 years. And that's just to show Uncle Cal, Divina, that your dad always had you in mind. And he always took care of his family. And that's one of the things I'm going to miss about him. And on this very sad day, I hope you know that he's always in your graces. Bye-bye.
Hi, Divina, Shivana, Avinash, Auntie Marina. So sorry to hear of Uncle Calvin's passing. We're gonna miss him so. We have such loving, fun memories of him. God bless his soul. May he continue to watch over you as he did in life. He's now your angel. Love you all. Bye.
Hello, for those, for everyone and those watching, I'm Rishi Inalsingh, proudly the nephew of dear Uncle Raj. Just some of the few words that we would use to describe Uncle Raj: warm, generous, humble, calm, cool, intelligent, gentle, and musical, with an ever-ready, genuine smile and true sense of humor. As a doctor, along with his personality and his experience, he touched thousands of lives, not just here in Trinidad and Tobago, but also around the world through his travels too. So in summary, I would think of Uncle Raj as the best ambassador Trinidad and our family, the Inalsingh family, could ever, ever have. On behalf of Avinash, his son, I'd like to say, dearest Daddy, I am blessed to have had such an incredibly capable father who I could go to for anything, everything, and at absolutely any time. You always knew what to do in life and how to help, whether good or bad, and also a lot about love and health. Being the two men in our family, you were at the same time my very best friend with your wicked sense of humor and all of the boys' jokes too. I have lost a great father and my best friend at the same time. This is an unimaginable loss for me. The price of love is grief. And today, we all honor, respect, and miss a very great man who has touched and enriched all of our lives and so many more in so many ways. Dear Uncle Raj, you will live on in our hearts and memories always.
Hello from Manchester, England. Uncle Calvin has been such a staple of my childhood memories and growing up, and all very, very great memories from down the islands to, you know, before the pool was built, in that there was a huge tree. We used to go like hang out and climb, and a lot of my early memories has been of coming up to Ragbear Street and Uncle Calvin and so on and so forth. But one of my biggest memories, and continuous and one of the biggest probably impacts of my being, is he always asked me, how's music and how's my music, you know? I don't think anybody else in my family asked me that question, but every time I saw him throughout the years, he used to say, hey, how's the guitar playing? And I felt as though we always had that kind of musician connection. But he always asked me that, and that's something I will always...
Miss the sound of your voice and the wisdom of your advice and your presence. How you uplifted me. You've touched countless lives in your lifetime through your good deeds. These are the words of a song that depict you. There's a candle in every soul. Some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There's a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes its home. These are my memories of you. On behalf of the Prasad family, we wish to thank you for the time that you've spent with us. We wish we could sit and smile and talk again as we used to. We will still feel the pain of your loss. But what remains in our hearts is your memories, and that will last forever. So rest peacefully, our friend, brother-in-law, and uncle. We will miss you always. It was always a joy to have you around.
Hey everyone, it's Elvis Grant Phillips. I just wanted to express my gratitude for the time, the relationship that I had with Dr. Inalsingh. He was an amazing human being that really cared about fighters and humanity in general. A wonderful, wonderful human being that I will never forget. And I know that God has an amazing new addition to his kingdom. May you rest in peace. You will always be remembered.
Hello, everyone. Janice and I are very sad to hear the passing of our great friend, Calvin Inalsingh. We have known Calvin and his beautiful family for decades and decades. And Janice and I have traveled the world taking care of athletes under the guidance and advice and companionship of Calvin. It's a great loss to us, to the boxing world, to his family, to his country, and to the Association of Ringside Physicians, who also so valued his leadership. God bless our friend Calvin. Again, our blessings and our peace go to his family. Thank you.
We love you.
Good morning. I'm recovering from this nasty flu, so if I sound a little nasal, that's the reason. I stand here, by the way, my name is Imber, Clement Imber. Shivana is not Imbert, it's Imber. Imbert is a little fella in Port of Spain. You can call him that if you want. Yeah, I stand here in two capacities. One as a very good friend of Calvin, and also as his former deputy and now successor as a president of the Prince Elizabeth Home for Handicapped Children. I noticed, Dr. Benjamin, didn't use the word handicap. It's not politically correct these days, but that's the official name of the home. And as I'm on the topic of Dr. Benjamin, he has put me in a very peculiar position by saying that somebody should be listening in the audience and do something and name something for Dr. Inalsingh at the home. Dr. Benjamin, you didn't have to do that in the public. So, but it's not a bad position in which to be put. Let me first say how I knew Dr. Inalsingh. It was 1967, I believe. I was just still in my teens, 1967. He was the DMO in Sangro Grande, and he also worked at the hospital. And one Sunday, I had the worst stiff neck that you could ever think about. And I told a friend, listen, I have to go to the hospital and get some kind of injection or something. They said, no. Listen, you don't know what the hospital will do. Why you don't go up to Dr. Inalsingh? Well, my father was a magistrate, and we used to live in the magistrate's quarters in St. Grandy when I was very young. And after the magistrate quarters was the Wassa building, and then it was the DMO's office. So I was very familiar with the DMO's office and all around there when I was a little guy running about the place. So I said, fine, I know where it is. So I went up there and I told him, I said, Dr. Inalsingh, sorry to disturb you on a Sunday. He says, no, come. I have heard about you. I say, you have heard about me? He said, yes, you are a champion billiard player, aren't you? I was a champion billiard player in my teens. Huh? So he said, listen, come, what's the problem? So he gave me an injection. He called it a muscle relaxant right in my neck. And then he said, come, I want to show you something. So he showed me a Skittles board. I said, Doc, with all due respect, that is a game for children. Why you don't come and play billiards with us? So he said, well, fine, where? I said, well, I don't know if you'll want to come, you know, it's in the back room of a rum shop, you know. You have to pass through the rum shop with all the jammets and the badgeons and then get to the billiard room, you know. He says, no, that's all right. And, you know, it's a testament to his, as Dr. Benjamin said, his willingness to mix with all types of people, that he came, became a very good player, became a member of our team, and we actually won the Interclub Championship in 1973. It was, and he was a part of the team. We made the papers, as they say, in Trinidad and Tobago. It was the Sunday Mirror, March the 11th, 1973. I never forgot it. I cut it out. I still have the old clipping at home. And we had a nice picture of the team in the snacket in the rum shop. And the guy who ran the rum shop, you know, these guys always have a nickname, Pirate. His name was Clive Francis, but Pirate to everybody. When he wanted to respectfully even call him Mr. Pirate, he would show all the miserable people in the billiard room, particularly. He said, listen, you see that picture there? That one is a doctor, and the other one is an engineer, you know. These are the kinds of people who come to my place, so you better behave. And that picture stood there until they closed down the rum shop, and Pirate died. I don't know. I have a copy of the picture. And so that is how I first met him, and we became friends since. So that is since he was the DMO. When he moved to St. Augustine, he acquired a billiard table, as Dr. Benjamin said, and it was at the back of his mother's store. And as he said, a lot of champions from all over the country would come and play. And he mentioned Mastiffy. He was one of the best billiard players in Trinidad and Tobago, but he was known as a real bad man. But he never liked the sobriquet, if you like, of Abajon. Masisi will tell you, I only got into fights to prevent advantage. That was his mantra. So you never could call Masifu Abajon. His name, by the way, was Eugene De La Rosa. And in 1951, he was the runner-up to the national billiard champion, John Remy. One of the best. I also used to play with him in a club in Tunapuna when I was at university called Paul Club, opposite the police station. It was broken down and so on. And I became, if you like, good friends with Masifu. When I would walk from Tunapuna, where I was staying, to university, I'd see him. He was a foreman with the county council, they called it at that time, St. George's, I think. Anyway, that's how I met him, and we became friends, very good friends since then. About 20 years ago, he told me, he always asked me about advice of anything related to engineering. And whether I knew it or not, I would try to help. Because although I graduated with my undergrad degree as a mechanical engineer, I worked with civil engineers and so on, and I consider myself an all-around engineer. So I would always give whatever advice or get advice from other people to assist with whatever. But about 20 years ago, he told me, he said, listen, we have a lot of engineering problems in the Prince Elizabeth home. And I would like you to come on board. But there was no space at the time because the Prince Elizabeth home, there are specific people, the Red Cross, the Child Welfare League, the Coterie, and so on. But then about 2 years later, 2 or 3 years later, a vacancy arose. That is the president of the country has won nomination on the council of the Prince Elizabeth home. He said, you know, there's a vacancy, so I want you to come and join officially. I would help, but so I said, fine. He said, but I can't tell the president that I want you to be a member. And I said, listen, Max and myself were colleagues. Don't worry, I know Max very well. So I'll get around it. But of course, I didn't want to approach the president, although we are friends, if you like, we are colleagues in the university, to tell him that. So I use an intermediary. And 3 days later, Max called me. He says, Clem, I want to appoint you to the Prince Elizabeth Home Board. What do you think about it? I said, that's fine. I have been, in fact, been associated with them for a little while. That's fine. And he laughed. He said, you know, they have no money in it. You know, there's a board that don't have no stipend, you know. So I laugh and I said, Max, I will make my money otherwise. Don't worry, no man. It is not, well, I didn't say Max, sorry. I said, sir. Yeah, I never called the big man Max, especially when he was president. Even when he was a colleague of mine, he was much older than I am. I never call him Max. I always call him Prof. And when I became a prof, he'd call me Prof too. But he'd call me Clem. And that is how I came onto the Prince Elizabeth home. And he then insisted that I should be the deputy chair. I said, fine. And a couple of years ago, about 3 years ago, he kept telling me, he says, you know, Clem, I'm not working and active. You should now be the president. And I said, no, doc. As long as you are able, I will be your deputy. Last year, he then told me, he said, listen, there's an election coming up, and I really can't make an Oakland. You have to become the president. I say, okay, only with your blessings. And he recommended it, and I'm now the president there, serving for the last 17 years, mainly as his deputy and his assistant. And I think for the last 17 years or close to that, I would pick him up every day, every meeting, every month when we had our meetings, go to the meetings and drop him back home. And as I say, that was just not all. We have always been very good friends, He would never charge me when I went to him as a doctor, or he wasn't a doctor before he stopped working. And I had to force him. I said, "Doc, I have insurance. Just sign the insurance form now. I have insurance, so let me pay you something." He still would refuse. So I got insurance money under false pretenses. Because he never charged me, but he put some figure there. That was the doc. I could spend all the rest of the morning, but there are some ceremonies that have and activities that have to take place about myself and the doc going all over the country playing billiards, all over the country, including my hiker in the south, wherever, for years. But I'll stop here and say how honored I am that most of the tributes I saw were from family members, but I consider him my older brother also. Thank you very much.
Hello, family and friends of Dr. Calvin Inalsingh. My name is Dr. Kyle Beard. Calvin was a great man to many people. I knew him as a physician, ringside physician, colleague, father, and friend. Calvin was always very kind, polite, and gracious. His smile would light up the room wherever he went. He was very funny and witty. I had the pleasure of spending some time with him recently in Trinidad in January. He loves music, keyboards and guitar. Most recently, playing guitar, he played while we sang. Well, he sang mostly. I was there for my birthday. We went to a shark and bake and then had a traditional lime on the beach with family, friends, and cooked food and rum. Calvin, you are already missed and loved. We'll see you again in glory. God bless.
I just want to say thank you to everyone who shared a tribute. And even all the personal messages and the WhatsApps and the calls from around the world, the emails, the everything. And for everyone who is here today to show your love and support of our family and respect to our dad, thank you so much.
I made mention of this already, that this is the Easter season. Without exaggeration, I know that there are millions around the world during this Lenten season, right on to Good Friday and Easter, who will be singing the hymn, "On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame, the emblem of hope, a reminder of glory, of the one who gave his life, the dearest and the best, for a world of lost sinners." The closing hymn, and we stand for that. Thank you all very much. God bless you. Try the chorus. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Oh, that old rugged cross, so despised by the world, has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross for a crown. In the old rugged cross, stained with blood so divine, a wondrous beauty I see. For 'twas on that old cross Jesus suffered and died to pardon and right, I know you've been following your program. We have the committal at this time. Now, you are familiar with these words. All the priests would say this. In all religions, there is a committal, and the priests would say it. But you know what we will do today? You will share with me. I don't think I am worthy. Now that I have lived so long, sometimes I feel very unworthy to do some of these things alone. Will you say it with me? For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God to call unto himself the soul of our beloved Calvin Inalsingh, we therefore commit his body to be cremated, earth to earth, dust to dust, and ashes to ashes, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ, who shall change the body with all its weakness and imperfections, that it may be like unto his glorious body. We hold fast to this promise for eternal life in the name of God our Creator and through Jesus Christ, the Lord of the resurrection and the Holy Spirit, the divine comforter, now and forever. You play the amen, and we closing this in most services. We close with what is called the threefold amen. Bow your heads in prayer, and we sing. Amen. 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 Thank you very much, and please be seated. God's blessing to all of you. Shivana, help me. The body is going to be taken, I'm reading from your program, to the room for cremation. Okay? Right, so those who are assisting, kindly come. We all stand.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home. Teardrop in my eye, country roads, take me home to the place.
You to my twin brother Calvin.
Hi folks, that's me. And may I in return introduce you to my twin brother Raj. Come on, Raj, if you
want. That's me, folks.
Lovely.
What an introduction. Anyhow, Calvin, how about singing along with me?
Sure, man. You name the number and I'll sing along with you. What would you like to sing?
How about singing Hand Me Down My Walking Cane?
That's a lovely tune. You go ahead and I'll follow you.
Hand me down,
oh hand me down,
my walking cane,
my walking cane.
Hand me down,
oh baby hand me down,
my walking cane,
my walking cane.
Hand me down my walking cane, I'm gonna meet that midnight train, cause all my sins are taken away. Hand me down,
oh hand me down,
my bottle of corn,
my bottle of corn.
Hand me down,
oh baby hand me down,
my bottle of corn,
my bottle of corn.
Hand me down my bottle of corn, I'm gonna get you as sure as you're born, cause all my sins are taken away. I got drunk,
oh I got drunk,
and got into jail,
and got into jail.
I got drunk,
oh baby I got drunk,
and got into jail,
and got into jail.
I got drunk and got into jail. I had no wife to pay my bail, cause all my sins are taken away. If I had listened,
if I had listened
to what Mama had said,
to what Mama had said,
if I had listened,
oh, if I had listened
to what Mama had said,
to what Mama had said,
if I had listened to what Mama had said, I'd be sleeping on a feather bed, cause all my sins are taken away. Down.
Oh, hand me down,
oh, my walking cane,
my walking cane.
Hand me down,
oh, baby, hand me down,
my walking cane,
my walking cane.
Hand me down, my walking cane, I'm gonna meet that midnight train, cause all my sins are taken away.
Very good, Calvin.
Oh, thank
what
you very
like
much.
To sing again?
Oh, what about Try and Return to Me? That's a lovely number.
Okay, we'll sing that one, sure.
Okay, you go ahead and I'll follow you.
Return to me, oh my dear, I'm so lonely. Hurry back, oh my dear, hurry back, I am yours. Return to me, for my heart wants you only. Hurry back, hurry home, oh my dear, hurry home to my heart. My darling, if I hurt you, I'm sorry. Forgive me, and please say you are mine. Return to me, please come back, bella mia. Hurry back, hurry home, to my arms, to my lips and my heart. My darling, If I hurt you, I'm sorry. Forgive me, and please say you are mine. Return to me, please come back, Bella Mia. Hurry back, hurry home, to my arms, to my lips and my heart. Return to me, return to me, return to me.
Thank you very much.
That was very nice, Calvin.
Don't mention it,
Rob. Remember the days. We used to follow this song closely by another one.
Okay, I know it.
Oh, it was Bonacera.
Bonacera, that's right.
Bonacera.
That's right. You well, I'll play along with you.
Bonacera, senorina, bonacera. It is time to say goodbye to Napoli. It is hard for us to whisper bonacera with that old moon above the Mediterranean Sea. And in the morning, senorina, we'll go walking where the mountains and the sands come into sight. By the little jeweler shop we stop and linger while I buy a wedding ring for your finger. In the meantime, let me tell you that I love you. Bonacera, senorina, kiss me goodnight. Bonacera, senorina, bonacera. It is time to say goodbye to Napoli. Lord, it's hard for us to whisper bonacera with that old moon above the Mediterranean Sea. In the morning, senorina, we'll go walking where the mountains and the sands come into sight. By the little jeweler shop, we stop and linger while I buy a wedding ring for your finger. In the meantime, let me tell you that I love you. Bonacera, senorina, kiss me goodnight.
Very nice, Calvin. Very nice. What about another one? You know, Calvin, I always knew you love He'll Have to Go. Do you remember that one?
Lovely tune, lovely tune.
Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell love is blind. Make up your mind, I've got to know. Should I hang up or will you tell him he'll have to go? You can say the words I want to hear while you with another man. Will you answer me yes or no? Darling, I will understand. Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you, you have to go.
Very nice, Raj.
Calvin, do you remember the one, Oh Boy?
That's a lovely tune, Oh Boy.
Quite a lot.
Yes, we used to play it a lot in Sweden.
All my love, all my kisses, you don't know what you've been missing, Oh Boy. When you're with me, Oh Boy, I want the world to know that you were meant for me. All my life I've been waiting, tonight there'll be no hesitating, Oh Boy. When you're with me, Oh Boy, I want the world to know that you were meant for me. Stars are fair, shadows are falling. You can hear my heart calling. A little bit of love with everything right. I'm gonna be your baby tonight. All my love, all my kisses. You don't know what you've been missing, Oh Boy. When you're with me, Oh Boy, I want the world to know that you were meant for me. Stars are fair, shadows are falling. You can hear my heart a-calling. A little bit of love with everything right. I'm gonna be your baby tonight. All my love, all my kisses. You don't know what you've been missing, Oh Boy. When you're with me, Oh Boy, I want the world to know that you were meant for me.
Very nice, Raj. Please, let's have another one.
You should always follow that one, you know. You know which one?
I shall not be moved.
I shall not be moved.
Thank you very much.
Yes, that's it.
I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's standing by the water. I shall not be moved. Judas in my knapsack, I shall not be moved. Keep Judas in my knapsack, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's standing by the water, I shall not be moved.
I shall not be moved.
Just like a tree that's standing by the water, I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved.
Very nice, Raj. Please, let's go ahead, man. We're not getting the rhythm. We're getting right into it.
I think everybody's going out and having fun.
That's a lovely tune.
What do you think, Calvin? Well, let's do that one, man. Everybody's going out and having fun.
Everybody's going out and having fun. I'm just a fool for staying home and having none. A lonesome fool just blind and just can't see. Oh, lonesome me. A bad mistake I'm making by just hanging around. I know that I should have some fun and paint the town. A lonesome fool just blind and just can't see. Oh, lonesome me. She's not like me, she's out fancy free, floating with the boys with all her charm. But I still love her so, and brother, don't you know, I'll welcome her right back into my arms. There must be some way I could lose these lonesome blues, forget about the past and find somebody new. I walk about her every single day, you see. Oh, lonesome me.
Thank you, kids.
Listen to the ocean, one of our very nice tunes.
Thank you,
Sing that one, Carl.
We are going to sing that one now.
There's a world of sun and sand, full of sky and far from land, where evening breezes caress the shores like a gentle comforting hand. Fragrant blossom, honeybees, careless laughter upon the trees, and lovers fade into pools of deep purple shadows among the trees. Listen to the ocean. Echoes of a million seashells, forever its emotion. Moving to a rhythmic and unwritten music that's spiritually. The sound of the seagulls, listen bright, his wing-like for enters is drawn in.